Anybody else? I got a comment. I'd like to commend Chris Throgmorton for his cooperation and his assistance with the county prosecutor to take a possible sex offender off the street. So with that, that's what the community needs, is people to be engaged. You see something that doesn't look right, by God, tell somebody. So thank you, sir.
I have one.
I would. Yeah. You got something?
Yeah.
While he's coming up, I would say the same thing as a 60-year teacher coach. You don't realize the effect you've had on not only that child, but his entire family. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
You got a prepared statement? Is that what that is?
I do. I'll try to keep it short. Okay. I wrote it all out. It's all within the confines of all our county good rules for public comment.
Maybe start the clock. All right, go ahead. No, I'm just kidding.
All right. I'd just like to start out informally by saying I'm a father. I have two small boys, so I did what I feel anybody would have or at least should have done. That being said, I'm going to go ahead and read. Good evening. I'd like to thank Earl specifically and the council for inviting me here for this tonight. However, I don't want to say decline, but I guess forward your praise and thanks to the community in general. While I am credited with doing the majority of the research into Michael Christianson's activities, there were several community members that forwarded me relevant information that they discovered along the way, as well as kept vigilant over the years. Our community did an outstanding job of spreading awareness through social media, a very powerful tool for the ordinary citizen when used properly, for letting this monster know that we are keeping an eye on things. However, I believe our community is owed more than a thank you. I feel that the members of this community deserve an explanation as to why they had to step up and take care of this. Between 2016 and 2019, LaPorte County received over $500,000 in Edward J. Byrne federal grant funding for our Internet Crimes Against Children Task Force that our prosecutor, Mr. John Lake, shut down about a month after he took office in 2019. About 6 or 7 months before the FBI ultimately arrested Mr. Christianson on matters the community had already alerted local law enforcement as well as this task force to almost a year prior. We still do not know what happened to this money, but I believe this is a great night to talk about how well it is spent and keeping track of, because it is the people's money, and we still don't know what it was used for, if not to facilitate the very task that this community stepped up to perform in law enforcement's absence. We deserve to know if it was a failure on our dime. We deserve to know that. Today, I am humbled by your appreciation, but tomorrow, I will continue my search for an explanation. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.